क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री,
यस सर,
या क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री इज 25x² + 30x + 7 = 0. We have to say what is the nature of the roots. Comparing with standard form ax² + bx + c = 0, a is equal to 25, b is equal to 30, c is equal to 7. Now to find, we need to find what is the value of delta is equal to b² - 4ac is equal to, what is b? B square, 30² - 4 × what is a? 25. What is c? 7. Now this is equal to 30² = 900. -25, 4 = 100. 100 × 7, 700. So 900 - 700 will be 200, which is what? Greater than zero. So delta greater than zero means the nature of roots. Roots are real and distinct. Real and distinct. One more question, tell me.
Sir, sixth one, sir.
Sixth one. That is the equation I am writing. 2x² - 2√6x + 3 = 0 is the equation of the quadratic. Now comparing with ax² + bx + c = 0, a is equal to 2, b is equal to -√6, c is equal to 3. Now to find, we have to know the value of discriminant. Delta is equal to b² - 4ac is equal to, b square means -√6² -4 × a = 2, c = 3. Now this is minus square we have now, that's why it will be plus. 2² = 4 × √ √ 6 -4 × 8 = 24. Now this is equal to 24 - 24 = 0, where delta is equal to 0 means discriminant 0. Therefore the nature of roots, roots are equal. When the roots are equal, delta is equal to 0. When the roots are real and distinct, delta greater than 0. When the roots are imaginary, delta less than 0. Understand?
Yes, sir. Sir, example 7 also. Once again.
Say. Okay, okay. Copy this, sir. కొంచెం యా ఎగ్జాంపుల్ 7 ఆ
ఎస్ సర్
Find the set of values for k which the equation kx² + 2x + 1 = 0 has distinct real roots. So distinct real roots means, just now we completed here one question. This distinct real roots means discriminant delta greater than 0. Let this is equation number 1, and comparing with ax² + bx + c = 0. The value of a is equal to k, and the value of b is equal to 2, and the value of c is equal to 1. Since given real and distinct, real and distinct, delta greater than 0. Delta greater than 0. If given only real, you can take delta greater than or equal to 0. If given real and distinct, delta greater than 0. Okay. Now, what is delta? b² - 4ac > 0. What is b? 2² - 4ac. What is a? k. What is c? 1 > 0. Now, 4 - 4k > 0. Then you will get what? 4k less than 4, taking that set 4k less than 4, 4 1 ja, 4 1 ja, k less than 1. K less than 1 means what? K belongs to the values, don't write flower bracket, the values minus infinity to 1 open. All values except minus infinity except 1 exist. So we can write what? Solution set is equal to K belongs to real numbers.
Sir, 1 also we should put in flower normal bracket, sir.
Where K belongs to real numbers such that what? K less than 1. K less than 1. The values of K, we have to take all real numbers but should less than 1. What you will get less than 1? 0, minus 1 up to minus infinity. Except to minus infinity. You can write this one or this one. Any one of these two is enough. Okay. Next question. Yes, sir.
That must be, sir.
Yeah, now one more.
See, sir, near 1 also we should put normal bracket, sir. Here, sir. Near 1.
This only open bracket. Why? Because there is no equal to symbol, right?
Yes, sir.
If you have equal symbol, you have to write closed bracket.
Yes, sir.
I will tell you about bracket. I will tell you bracket, types of bracket. Listen carefully. Listen, suppose if you have set A is equal to A, don't take A, B, C, D. Suppose all natural numbers up to 15. Suppose this is the set. Okay. If you want to write from this set only, don't take up to 15. Equipotemali number up to 10. If you want to write only even numbers, even numbers set, then what are the even numbers? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 also. If you take 10, if you not take up to 8. So we can write, if you use flower bracket, first I'm telling about flower bracket. You have to write all numbers 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. The meaning of flower bracket means what you are writing in the bracket, those only consist. That is the meaning of flower bracket. So your real numbers you have to write, na? That's why you have to write every number. How many numbers between 1 to 10? How many numbers you have between 1 to 10 or 1, 9, 10? Those all even numbers you have to write. Suppose if you use closed bracket, same even number. If you use closed bracket, you have to write 2 comma 10. If you use closed bracket, 2 to 10, all even numbers. You have to start from 2, you have to end at 10. So this 10 and 2 include. That is the meaning of closed bracket. So now what are the numbers exist? Same number. 2, you have to start from 2. Don't leave 2. You have to start from 2. 4, 6, 8 and 10 also. That is the meaning of closed bracket. If you use open bracket, then you have to write open 1 comma open 11. So here you have to exclude 1, start from 2. You have to exclude 11. Before 11 you have to count. That is, by excluding 1, what is the next number? And that should be even number. 2, then 4, then 6, then 8, then 10, then 12. But 11 is not include, that is exclude. So before 11 you have to count, that is 10. So that is the meaning of open bracket. And if you use one closed bracket, one open bracket. Closed means we should count. So take 2 comma up to 11. So don't count 11. And before 11, what is the real number? That is 10. And you should count 2. Why? Because we are writing here closed. Na? From 2 you have to count 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 11. That is not countable. Why? Because we are writing what? Open bracket. Open means we should exclude. closed means we should include. Flower bracket means we should write only the particular number. What you want to write, that only you have to write. And the last one, open, closed. So open means you should not count, na? That's why I write first one. So we are not counting one. After one, we are counting. That is what? 2, 4, 6, 8, up to 10. So we should write here 10. Why? Because here we have closed bracket. Na? Closed means include. So we should count compulsory 10. That's why we should write closed bracket. So this is the information about brackets. So if you write flower bracket, you should write those particular numbers. Now what I wrote here? X less than 1. X less than 1 means less than, not less than or equal to. Lesser than 1 means the values are what? 0, minus 1, minus 2, up to minus infinity. That's why I wrote what? X belongs to minus infinity. Always for infinity we should write open only. Why? Because we can't count infinity. That's why open. This is exclude. We don't count minus infinity. After minus infinity we can count. Up to where? 1 open means before 1 we should count. Means what? 0 exists there. If you want to write here closed bracket, then write like this. 0 closed. We can write like that also. But in between 0 and 1 also we have more real numbers. 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. That's why it is better to write 1 open. If given here some natural numbers, integers like that, we can use closed bracket also. So this is about information of brackets. Understand or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now one more question that is different from previous classes, that is what? About imaginary roots. Till now we learnt about real roots and real distinct roots and real and equal roots. Now we will discuss about imaginary roots. The question is, show that the equation, example 8. Show that the equation 3x square plus 7x plus 8 equal to 0. Show that the equation 3x square plus 7x plus 8 equal to 0 is not true for any real number. Is not true for any real number of x. Not true for any real number of x means it is true for imaginary numbers. Means we should get the value of discriminant delta less than 0, then we can say directly this is not satisfied any real number. This is having no any real root. Okay. Now comparing with standard form, ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. The value of a is 3. The value of b is 7. The value of c is equal to 8. We have to prove this equation having no real roots, having no real solution, having no real factors. So that's why delta should less than 0. Now I am finding delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. I am finding. What is b value? 7. So 7 square minus 4 into what is a? 3. What is c? 8. Now 7, 7 ja 49 minus 4, 3 ja 12. 12, 8 ja 96. Clearly 49 minus 96 is less than 0. Na? So that is, what is the value? 49, 50, 47, minus 47. So therefore delta is clearly less than 0. Therefore this quadratic equation is not true for any real number of x. The total sentence we have to write. The given equation not true for any real number for x. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this type of questions I will give you, and I will give you one more also in this class, complete first. Yeah, see here, example 9. Show that the equation 2 into a square plus b square into x square plus 2 into a plus b into x plus 1 equal to 0 has no real roots. Same we have to prove. This is also has no real roots. Has no real roots if A not equal to B. So see here, by comparing this equation AX square plus BX plus C is equal to 0. This total X square coefficient is A. This total X coefficient as B. And this one is C. Now, I'm writing A is equal to 2 into A square plus B square. A is equal to 2 into A square plus B square, comma, B is equal to 2 into A plus B. This is BX, right? Plus C. So, C is equal to 1. But we have to find delta, that is B square minus 4AC is equal to, what is B square means? 2 into A plus B whole square. This is B square. B means this total, no, whole square. Minus 4, what is A? 2 into A square plus B square. B square minus 4A, what is C? 1. So this is equal to, see, 2 square, 4 into A plus B whole square. A plus B whole square. We have to apply square for both terms. What are in bracket? Now minus 4 to the 8 into A square plus B square. Now see, 4 into A square plus B square, A plus B whole square, right? So what I am doing, taking 4 common. Taking 4 common, what you will get here? A plus B whole square, that is A square plus B square plus 2AB. Next what? You are already taken 4 common, remaining minus 2 is there. Minus 2 into A square, minus 2A square, minus 2 into B square, minus 2B square. Understand this step, Jibin?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now what? 4 into, this is minus 2A square and A square will be minus A square. 2AB minus 2A square will be minus A square will be minus A square. Minus 2B square minus plus B square will be minus B square. Why? Because this is the big number, na? You will get the big number sign only minus. But there is no formula 2AB minus A square minus B square. That's why I'm taking minus common. Taking minus common, what you will get? Minus 4 into, this will be positive and this will be positive and this is negative, minus 2AB. And A square plus B square minus 2AB is nothing but A minus B whole square. So this is what? Minus 4 into A minus B whole square. See, A is a constant, B is a constant, A minus B also some constant whole square. That is positive. But positive into negative is negative. So we can write this is less than 0. Therefore, we got what? Delta less than 0. Therefore, what we have to write? This equation has no real roots. That is the solution. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay? Right. Copy faster. Time, yes, complete. More 3 minutes there. No problem. Copy.